In this video, we're going to take a look at the Free Look camera component in Cinemachine. We're going to look at how Free Look can be used to orbit a transform based on input from an axis. We're also going to look at how we can customize the Free Look camera component to get our intended composition on each stage of input. In this demo, we have a ship that the player can control and are currently locked off a virtual camera, following the transform as it moves around the screen. It's common in games like this for the player to have control of the camera, so that they can get a look ahead around corners, or simply get a better, more preferable angle of their avatar. Cinemachine's Free Look camera component allows us to set up an axis-controlled camera that orbits a target. To get started, let's create a new Cinemachine Free Look camera. We'll deactivate the old follow camera, and then in our new free look camera, assign the look at and follow property to the ship. Now, if we play, we can see that as the mouse moves, our camera orbits around the ship. However, it needs some fine tuning. Back in the inspector, let's slow down the speed of the x-axis to get a smoother movement on the camera rotation as our mouse moves from left to right. We'll turn off invert too, as I'd like the camera to aim towards where I'm pointing my mouse. The Free Look camera blends between three different rig states, a top rig, a middle rig, and a bottom rig. Cinemachine does this to give us much more control over the position and composition of our camera at different stages of orbit. In the scene view, we can see the Free Look gizmo showing us a wireframe representation of our settings. If we change a rig height or radius, we can see the gizmo update in the scene view. To preview what the camera looks like at different positions on the rig, we can simply change the value setting of the X or Y axis in the inspector. From here, we can adjust the camera composition with the aim settings in the same way we would with any other Cinemachine camera, either by using the guides or adjusting the values in the inspector. If we change the value on the y-axis, the guides will switch to the corresponding part of the rig. If, for instance, we'd like to change the field of view on the camera at a certain point in the rig, such as when the camera is low to the ground, we can disable the Use Common Lens Settings toggle and customize the lens setting for each of our aim properties on our rig. Finally, by changing the spline tension on our rig, we can adjust how the camera moves between each point. A lower value causes a linear blend between the states, and a higher value will create a curved movement. From here, we can simply adjust and tweak our aim and rig values to get the best settings for our project. It's also worth noting that we can animate the values of the Free Look camera for use in cutscenes, or control it with custom scripts. Should we wish to remove control input from the player, we can simply remove the input axis name property. We can then drive the value property manually using an animator, or by referencing our Free Look component in a custom script and setting the m_x-axis or m_y-axis value. As you can see, the Free Look camera component in Cinemachine makes it easy and simple to create a user-controlled camera in our project. For more information on Cinemachine, and for more Unity tutorials, please follow the links below. Thanks for watching.